Michael, cool off, you know. Why did I have to come in here? Without a picking on me? My scripture comes from St. John, the 19th chapter, the 26th and the 27th verse. And it reads, when Jesus therefore saw his mother and his disciples standing by whom he loved, he said unto his mother, woman, behold thy son. Then said he to the disciple, behold thy mother. And from that hour, that disciple took her unto his own home. Right. And my words are, behold thy son, behold thy mother.
Yeah, right.
And this is the third saying of Jesus from the cross at Calvary, recorded by St. John, one of the 12 disciples. And this is one of the most tenderest scenes at Calvary.
Right.
Jesus and his mother,
uh-huh.
The closest earthly companion he had known.
Right.
And we seem to forget that although Jesus had a heavenly father, he also had an earthly mother.
Right.
And they had a good son and mother relationship.
Right.
When Jesus' parents went to Jerusalem to worship, and Jesus tarried behind, after 4 days they found him in the temple. And it was his mother who said to him, son, not child, not boy, not Jesus, but son. And Jesus was obedient to his mother. Luke 2:51 says, talk about Jesus, and he went down with them and came to Nazareth and was subject to them.
All right.
And Mary was present at some of the most important events in the life of Jesus.
All right.
John tells us that the third day there was a marriage in Cana of Galilee.
Yeah, yeah.
And the mother of Jesus was there.
All right.
And both Jesus was called and his disciples to the marriage. And when they wanted wine, the mother of Jesus said unto him, they have no wine.
All right.
And Jesus said unto her, woman, what have I to do with thee?
All right.
Mine hour is not yet come. Jesus was telling her that it wasn't time for him to demonstrate his power.
All right.
But his mother said unto the servant, whatsoever he says unto you, do it. And we know that Jesus honored their request because the governor of the feast said they served the best wine later.
All right.
And John tells us that this was the beginning of miracles Jesus did in Cana of Galilee.
Uh-huh.
And Jesus performed his first miracle because his mother,
yeah,
his mother, asked him.
All right.
And what a good relationship between mother and son. Uh-huh. The scripture also tells us, talking about Jesus, and after this he went down to Capernaum, and his mother, and his brethren, and his disciples, and they continued there not many days.
All right.
So now we have Mary at the crucifixion,
uh-huh,
Jesus hanging,
uh-huh,
in her standing.
All right.
And this must have been the most awful and good rent-wrenching experience of her life.
All right,
to see and experience,
yeah,
the crucifixion,
yeah,
of her son.
Yeah.
And the nail that went through his wrist,
come on now,
could have just as well gone through her wrist.
All right.
And the sword that pierced his side,
yeah,
could have just as well thrust her side.
All right.
Jesus' pain was her pain.
All right.
And that's the way it is with was lacerated from the beating that he had received. And all she could do was stand by the cross. And by this she was saying, "Son, I'm here. Son, I am with you in your hour of suffering and pain. Son, though others may forsake you, I will never forsake you." Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And who can grasp the grief of a son? The son who must watch his mother mourn. And although Jesus' pain was severe, his torture was unbearable. His burden was exhausting. And although his time was short, he realized he was not the only one hurt. His mother was hurt. And John, his beloved disciple, was hurt. And Jesus looked at his mother through dying eyes. And said to her through dying lips, behold,